Now that you've defined the NTRHD library, you want to see what's in the library. You can write a SAS program that creates a report containing information about the library and the files it contains. In this demonstration, you'll run the contents procedure to view the contents of the NTRHD library.
Like any procedure, we will begin by typing PROC and then the SAS keyword contents. We will tell SAS to perform this procedure on the data contained in the library called NTRHD. But instead of referencing a specific SAS dataset after the period, we will use the SAS keyword underscore all underscore after the period. This tells SAS that we want to view the general information about the library and list all the members of the library. The resulting report displays general information about the library, including the libref and the physical location of the file in the directory table. It also has a table that displays the members of the library in alphabetical order. Below that is a listing of the descriptor portions of the individual datasets. We will talk about those later. But if there are many datasets in the library, this section can be very lengthy. If you only want to see the general information and table of members for the library, you can include the NoDS option in the PROC statement, as is done in this example. Here, the descriptor portion of the individual datasets has been suppressed in the output.
A brief note on SAS datasets. SAS datasets actually have two distinct parts, a data portion and a descriptor portion. The data portion is pretty self-explanatory, and you've already viewed the data portion of SAS datasets using the print procedure and the view table window. The descriptor portion is where SAS saves information about the attributes of the dataset, such as the name of the dataset and the date it was created. The descriptor portion also contains information about each variable, such as the storage length, type, labels, and formats. You can use the contents procedure to view the descriptor portion of the SAS dataset. Now let's run the contents procedure again, this time to view the descriptor portion of the height underscore and underscore weight dataset.
Notice that this time, after the keyword data, we give the two-level dataset name for the dataset of interest instead of the libref and underscore all underscore. The report generated by PROC Contents gives us lots of information, such as the dataset name, when it was created, how many observations it contains, and how many variables it contains. At the bottom of the report, there is a table that has all the variables listed alphabetically along with the variables' attributes. But let's say you want to see a list of all the variables in the order that they appear in the dataset, as opposed to alphabetical order. All you have to do is add the varnum option to your PROC statement, like so. And now you see them in order. This is another one of those procedures that isn't all that useful with the small datasets we are currently using, but they may be helpful to you as you begin working with larger datasets.
You now know how to create libraries in SAS and permanently store SAS datasets. You also know two different SAS procedures for viewing the two different parts of a SAS dataset, PROC Print and PROC Contents. If you feel comfortable with this material, please move on to the lecture that covers importing data into SAS.